Hold up. It's that boy G-Plan. Don't give a damn. He cooler than a fan. Walking real tall, some say he's a man.
What's going on, man? Dallas Global.
Yes, sir.
We out here in Dallas, Texas, man. I want to say this before we even got into the building. When Change of Plans first shut down, our first Instagram got disabled. When we came back up, you were like the first blog or anybody like, hey, y'all follow Change of Plans. They got disabled, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. I appreciate you for doing that.
For sure.
Because bloggers don't do that.
Nah, that's a fact. When my page went down, we didn't get too many shots. Shout out to Arlington Urban. You know what I'm saying? Malik, he was like really one of the only blogs to really, you know what I'm saying, help us come back up. But I sure do appreciate it because, man, it's hard building a platform, man. It's hard on that. People think it's just Instagram and getting people to pay attention. It's hard to get people to stay paying attention to you. You know what I'm saying? It's hard to keep people attention. So I for sure appreciate y'all too because, bro, I check your page out all the time. You know what I'm saying? I look at your page. You keep me what's going on in Louisiana. You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm from. So, shit, I like to just know what's going on, and you that platform.
I appreciate it, man. It's hard. Man, you've been doing this for a while. Like I said, I appreciate you even acknowledging what I got going on. Some people don't even, they don't give me no credit. They just, oh, this Change of Plans is what it is, but you've been doing this consistently for years, you know what I'm saying? Now, I want to ask you this. Do you feel like you like the most hated blogger in Dallas?
Hell yeah, I'm not in Dallas. I'm the most hated blogger, period, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? They be hating, but it's all good. Like, I don't really give a fuck.
Like, how do you mentally stay sane?
I don't give a fuck about that shit. Like, niggas been, like, the thing is about blogging, like, I wasn't lame before I was blogging. You know what I'm saying? People already knew me. People know me. You know what I'm saying? I got a name, like, for real. So, it's like, people always not gonna like you. You know what I'm saying? Everybody not gonna like you. It's all good. It is what it is. But shit, like, Everybody feel like they got haters, you know what I'm saying? If you ain't got no haters, then the fuck is you doing? You know what I'm saying?
And I want to get straight into it, man. Like, before we even start rolling, you know, I saw what Goyea put up. I don't know him personally. I've seen him before.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he put out a message basically saying he's going to do this and that. And yeah. I'm like, damn, that's crazy. Like, and it got a big response to the blog world, too.
Man, nah, yeah, I seen Stay Down posted, you know what I'm saying? I ain't really get why they posted that. Like, they don't really just look good or whatever just for a rapper, but shit, it is what it is. He said what he said, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is.
Yeah, I wouldn't go do nothing. I saw it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, shit, like, everybody, bro, shit, that nigga, he turned my shit up that day. I ain't gonna lie. Like, man, my story had, like, fucking 5,000 people watch my story that day. I was like, damn, this nigga, he really got all these people looking at that shit. He just ain't do shit but turn my record, Instagram up. You know what I'm saying? That's really what it did.
Yeah, yeah. So what it's like, you know, you're originally from New Orleans. I've seen you say that before. Like, you out here in Dallas. Like, what's that, you know, you coming out here and trying to adapt to how Texas is going?
Man, I came out here real young. You know what I'm saying? When I first moved out here, it was in sixth grade, and I moved to Arlington. So, like, Arlington is a melting pot of everybody. Like, not just the DFW, period. You go meet people from everywhere here. You can meet somebody from Detroit, Chicago, Louisiana, California, New York. You go meet people from everywhere, you know what I'm saying? So, it really wasn't just like, when I first moved out here, I was really stuck in, like, a box, like, with the mentality. But I was still young, too, so, but I still had my people here. When we first moved, it was a lot of us. A lot of people went back to New Orleans. I ended up staying.
Was it for Katrina?
Yeah, first of all, when we moved out of New Orleans, we moved to Ohio first, and it was before Katrina. I moved to Ohio, I lived in Cincinnati, and then we moved to Pittsburgh. Then Katrina hit, I was living in Pittsburgh, but all my family was still in New Orleans. So my grandma, she worked for the Marines. She was moving to Dallas. We just ended up coming out here, moving to Dallas. And that's how I got here.
How often do you go back?
I go back all the time. So I just came back from the city not too long ago, like last month.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's crazy because we was in the message. I'm like, I was out here and you was out there. So, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I always go back, though. But, like, when I go back, I really don't be as much on the blogging stuff as I need to be. And it be hard getting over rappers because, like, it's like in different regions, people just only know what they see. Like, not too many people is tapped into, like, my platform in New Orleans yet, but it's growing. Like, it's always more people that end up, you know what I'm saying, tapping in, but it's not to the fact, like, here, nigga know Dallas Global. If I go to New Orleans, the average nigga go be like, I never heard of Dallas Global, you know what I'm saying? So, Yeah.
Who was the hardest part about branding Dallas Global? Like, you know, getting the name recognized. I see a lot of other globals and stuff now.
Yeah. It's,
I'm like, dang.
I always been a trendsetter, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, people always copy shit that I do. So.
Oh, so basically,
anything global after Dallas Global is a copycat. For real, how I feel. You know what I'm saying? I feel like the niggas copying me, but it's all good. Like, I ain't tripping. Like, it's all what we gonna do. Like, but I gotta, why you said that they got a nigga global media page that people think is related to Dallas Global. We ain't, I don't know who the fuck nigga global media is, but they be saying some funny shit, but like, sometimes they go overboard and they don't have nothing to do with Dallas Global. But yeah, shit. A lot of people be copying, bro. Like, that's just what it is.
Now, you from New Orleans. Right now, everybody's seeing the No Limit Chronicles and the Masterpiece stuff.
Yeah, I ain't got cable. I missed it. We got cable in the studio. I seen one of them. I missed it. I want to watch it. I got
to
catch up.
Well, this is my point I'm trying to get to. Master P, it's like, you know, we got to celebrate each other. We got to empower each other. You know, right now, you know, we about to do cross. We cross-promoting. Change of Plans platform. Dallas Global, Change of Plans. Like early politicians, TV, Stay Down, all these different people, whatever. Like, it's time for us, it's black media outlets for sure, to embrace each other and like, hey, let's help each other come up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The same thing as from Master P on. Nah. How do you feel about all of us, all these different bloggers coming together?
Man, I like it when we come together, bro, because like, if you're a blogger and you know me and you do this shit, like, you know, like, I'm the type of nigga that's going to try to help you come up. I'm going to give you some game. I'm going to put you in a position to help pop your page out, because shit, I know where I was at when I started doing it. You know what I'm saying? I ain't had nobody to help me do this shit. Like, I was really just out here doing it. So if why not help another, you know what I'm saying, platform come up too? Because the hotter all these platforms get, the hotter we make this area, the more people going to have to tap in with all of us, period. You know what I'm saying? I'm hot, but I can't be the only hot, but I can't touch every person. Like, we need all these people to, you know what I'm saying, do their job and connect with all these different people. We need that. Like, so I love to see that shit, but everybody don't have that mentality to see what's going on. Like, it's not a competition. It's basically like, we all got the same job and shit, we just got to do our job, basically, is how I look at it. But I love when I can actually come together and, you know what I'm saying, do something with another blog, because shit, why not?
And I'm glad you said that, because it made me think, see, in the state of Louisiana, we had some, like, I can say Nolazine TV, I don't know if you heard of them.
Yeah.
They doing their thing down there. But as far as being mobile, going here, going there, me personally, I don't think nobody doing it how I'm doing it. But I'm like, dang, like, I feel like I'm putting more work, I get more views, but somebody else might get more shine. I'm like, well, let me just keep on working. At the end of the day, we putting in work. It's not, it ain't no competition. We got to come together. So I get exactly what you're saying.
Facts. I mean, shit, the notoriety go come, though. Like, I really don't be worried about, like, who don't fuck with me. I really don't be worried about who don't fuck with the platform, because they see it. I know they see it. At this point, I know you see it. So it's all, and it's all about timing too. Like, even if I don't catch somebody one time, I might catch them further along down the road. Like, you might fuck with another blog, but shit, maybe it wasn't our time to crawl past. You know what I'm saying? Like, I used to think, like, when I first started, like, the bigger rappers, like, I used to be like, damn, why they ain't fucking with, you know what I'm saying, why they ain't fucking with us? But shit, a lot of, when I'm getting out and doing what I do, I see a lot of them really do, even if they don't say it on the platform. If they see me or something, they be like, man, I fuck, damn, you Dallas Global, I fuck with that. You know what I'm saying? So shit, I really just work at this point. It's all about the work.
And then one thing too, I think we two got in common. Like, I've been around a lot of artists. I've interviewed a lot of artists who popping. I'm not like a starstruck type guy. This ain't never been me. You heard me? So I seen you say, look, you're an artist. I don't dick ride, but I support. You know what I'm saying? And you honest. You really honest about a lot of stuff, and you make me feel some type of way.
But you
think that's the reason why they don't like you?
Fact. I mean, shit, it could be because, bro, I really do just say the first thing that pop up in my head. I really don't just think about it. And a lot of people be telling me, like, damn, like, I can say shit. I can say stuff better than how I say it, but it's just, like, it's just me. You know what I'm saying? I'm working on it, but shit, it is what it is, bro. Like, if you can't take the truth, then shit, it's on you. Like, because somebody they go tell you how they feel. You know what I'm saying? I would want somebody to tell me how you feel about whatever it is pertaining to me. So, shit, if you can't take it, then shit, I don't know what to tell you, my nigga.
Well, that's what you...